There has been a lot of discussion as of late with respect to foreign investment and interference in Canada's telecom, I guess, infrastructure. One of the stories I think that is, you know, that kind of comes to mind with respect to that is the disintegration of one of Canada's telecom giants, Nortel, and the comparisons in the past to Huawei's, I guess, rise at that same time. In your most recent piece, you have, I guess, there have been some parallels, the most striking parallels between those two companies.
Yeah, exactly. And, you know, people refer to Huawei as sort of the a champion of Chinese industry and technology. Nortel sort of basically filled the same role for Canada. It was a huge company, tech sort of darling. At one point, it accounted for something like a third of the worth of companies on the Toronto Stock Exchange, employed 90,000 people around the world. But basically, from sort of 2000 until it declared or went into bankruptcy protection in 2009, it sort of steadily declined. At the same time, Huawei rose, and by 2012, so a couple of years after sort of the death of Nortel, it was the largest maker of telecommunications equipment and data networking equipment in the world, and that was the industry that Nortel competed in. This sort of striking parallel between Huawei's rise and Nortel's fall, and there were a lot of sort of overlaps between the two companies over that period as well.
There have been allegations of cybersecurity breaches, specifically hacks. Huawei has said, well, you know what, Nortel went through a lot of poor management. Allegations that have never really been, I guess, that have never really criminally seen the light of day, correct?
Yeah, that's right. In terms of Nortel, there's never been any kind of criminal charges. And yet, as you mentioned, a few years after it sort of went under, it emerged that there had been this incredible hacking into their system over a long period of time, maybe over 10 years or even more, where they had access into the accounts of I think seven top executives, including the CEO of Nortel, and whoever was doing this, and it was traced back to China, was siphoning out like hundreds of Nortel internal documents about their marketing strategy, about products, and all kinds of sort of secret information. Over just 1 6-month period, the hackers got like 1,400 documents, and this was going on for years. So pretty sort of massive espionage. CSIS, as it turned out, again, after the fact we found out about this, had reported to Nortel earlier than that in the late 90s that there were human spies spying on Nortel, also linked to China. And later we found out about sort of bugs, listening devices that had been implanted in one of their facilities in Ottawa. A lot of stuff was going on that we didn't know at the time. Again, Huawei says they have had nothing to do with it, and a lot of analysts say, the demise of Nortel really had to do with other things like poor management and the dot-com bust when it lost a huge amount of value. But certainly there's some interesting parallels.
In your reporting, information that struck you the most, I mean, you had mentioned some of these little facts like some of these bugs or perhaps some of the equipment that was returned and it was re-engineered. Some of these interesting stories that you came across.
Yeah, some of this stuff has come out in the past. One thing I found out that was new, and this was from like three former security experts at Nortel who told me about this. There was an incident in Texas sort of around the year 2000 where Huawei or possibly a company representing Huawei had bought a piece of technology, sort of a computer device from Nortel, and then returned it. And they had bought it on credit actually and returned it and wanted a refund. And then Nortel started looking at this thing, and it turned out it had been pulled apart and sort of reverse engineered, you know, what a company might do if they wanted to figure out what made this thing run. So essentially they were trying to sort of copy or steal the technology that they had bought from Nortel. So, you know, some pretty sort of blatant stuff. And that, if you believe these three security people, ties directly to Huawei. The other things, the hacking and the spying, seems to have been done by people and actors in China. Whether Huawei was involved, we don't know. They certainly deny it.
There have been, I guess, some analysts that have speculated or have suggested, how is it possible for a company to grow so quickly, to rise so quickly, if not for extracurricular activities, if you will? How big of a telecommunications company is Huawei?
It is a giant. It is, in terms of the stuff that Nortel did, the telecommunications network equipment and data communications networking equipment, it is the biggest in the world. It surpassed Ericsson a few years ago. It's also, and this is a business Nortel was not in, it's also in making of smartphones, and it's, I believe, the second biggest in the world, and you know, ahead of Apple in terms of how many smartphones it sells. So it is, in terms of this kind of communications technology, it is a huge giant in the field.
With respect to what's happening now, U.S. prosecutors have, I guess, is it new information that they have, or they're working on old information? Bring us up to speed.
Yeah, well, they when Meng Wanzhou, the Huawei CFO, was arrested in Vancouver, I guess a little over a year ago, there was an indictment filed with charges against her that related to Huawei allegedly violating American sanctions on Iran. And then there was additional charges that didn't pertain to her specifically, but to the company, that dealt with alleged intellectual property theft. And that dealt with an incident involving T-Mobile in the US. The new indictment has basically sort of added to that, and there's now charges related to alleged intellectual property theft by Huawei against a total of six American companies. Now, a lot of these charges, they have come to light in the past in the form of civil suits by those companies against Huawei. This is now criminal charges that U.S. federal prosecutors have laid against Huawei. So sort of upping the ante, I guess, in a bit against Huawei.
As Huawei continues to push with their 5G technology, and especially here into Canada, how should policymakers be looking at this? I mean, they need to take into consideration all this information.
Yeah, I mean, what struck me in putting together this story again was sort of the close relationship between Huawei and Nortel. You know, there was talk of joint ventures and Huawei helping in a buyout of Nortel at the end and this kind of thing. And at the same time, this corporate espionage that has been traced back at least to actors in China and one incident that I was told about that involved Huawei specifically. It seems that although Nortel is dead and gone, it can't be brought back, this is a bit of history that perhaps lawmakers should be considering, you know, when they consider what role to allow Huawei to play in the next generation of wireless communications. It seems like a story that should be at least considered, I guess, in making these decisions.